Good morning, students. A very warm good morning to all of you. Today we are here with the some topics related to the mathematics, that is money. Okay, students, you have heard about the money, and in the fourth and the third standard also you have learn about the money. Okay, now see, some warm up is given there. Try true for T or false for F. When work is done, some money is earned. Yes, it is true or false? When the work is done, some money is earned. It is true. Then, all countries use the same currency? No, because all the countries are having its own currency, different currencies. Then, spending all your money leaves you with no saving. Yes, if you are spending all the monies with you, any saving is remaining? No, so it is the true. When you buy certain items, you get some money? Yes, no, it is false, because when you are buying some items, you just have to give the money to the shopkeeper, then it is the again false. Then E and F you have to do by your own. Then Gracie bought a diary for rupees 8.25, means 8 rupees 25 paise, and dictionary for 35 rupees 50 paise, and a bookmark for 50 paise. How much money should she spend in all? So for that, what you have to do, you just simply add the numbers. How much she got? That is 8 rupees 25 paise, then 35 rupees 50 paise, and the last is 50 paise, because in rupee paise you have to write here rupees and here paise. Okay, now it's 5, 12, carry 1, 14, 1, and is the 44. Means how much she spent? She just have to spend the 44 rupees 25 paise, that is 44 rupees 25 paise. Okay, now just moving to our the topic that is given. The first one is conversion of rupees and paise. Now you are already studied about how to convert the rupees and paise. Just see, we already learned about different denominations of coins and banknotes. Money is very important, as everything we use has some value, and anything valuable cannot be procured for free. Yes, anything is you are giving free? No, everything is having its value. Money involves earning, spending and saving. Yes, during a transaction, we sometimes need to convey money from paise to rupee and vice versa. Okay, so what is mean that during the transaction we sometimes need to convey money from paise to rupees and rupees to paise. Just see how we are converting rupees to paise. You know that 1 rupees is equal to 100 paisa, therefore 5 rupees is equal to 500 paise. Then 3 rupees 25 paise is equal to 3 rupees, means 300 paise, and 25 paise, so it is equal to 325 paise. Yes, now here rupees 4 rupees 30 paise to paise. So here you can see, when the number are in rupees, you just have to convert it to the paisa. So 4 rupees is equal to 400 paise plus 30 paise, so it is equal to 430 of paise. Okay, now just see, converting paise to rupees, we know 100 paise is equal to 1 rupees. To express the paise in rupees, the decimal point is used. You know, you are we are using the decimal point. So 25 paisa, when you are converting paise to rupees, you just have to divide it by 100. So when you are dividing it by 100, it will be equal to 0.25. while 325 paise is equal to 325 divided by 100, means it is equal to 3.25. okay, now see, 215 paise to rupees, so 215 divided by 100, so it is equal to, when you are divided by 100, just see the 2 point here, means the rupees are 2 rupees 15 paise. Okay, now see my practice time 1, change to paise. Okay, 8 rupees 50 paise, so 8 rupees is equal to 850, it is equal to 850 paise. Then 545, so 5 rupees equal to 500 plus 45 is equal to 545 paise. 645 means 600 plus 45, it is equal to 645 paise. Okay, in this way you know how to convert it, you just have to do by your own. Now see the second, change to rupees. 325 paise. So for that we have to do 325 divided by 100. So it is equal to 3.25 rupees. Okay, rupees you have to write in front. Then 725. So 725 divided by 100. It is equal to rupees 7.25. Okay. Now again 115 paise, you just have to divide 115 by 100, so it is equal to rupees 1.15. So you know when converting, when change to rupees, you just have to divide by 100, and when converting to paise, you just have to multiply it by rupees to 100. Now see, addition and subtraction involving money. We add or subtract money the same way as we do with numbers. The point between the numbers separates rupees from paise. So when you add or subtract, remember to put the point. Okay. Now see the question, examples are given there. If Rohit spends rupees 311.50 means 311 rupees 50 paise on a toy and 632.60 paise on a box of hand towels. So how much does he spend all together? Okay, for that what you have to do, you just have to add both the money, you will get the total. That is how much he spent. He just paid 944 rupees and 10 paise. Okay, in such a way Shahnawaz went to a shop with rupees 467. Okay, how much rupees is with him? That is 467 rupees with him, and he spent 243.40. Means he spent how much rupees? 243.40 means 243 rupees 40 paise. So how much will be left with him? So how much with him first? 467, and how much he spent? 243.40. Then how much is left with him? That is, you just have to subtract. What will be the answer is 223.60. Okay, now you know how to do the addition and subtraction. It is the simple like addition and subtraction, but here you just have to convert. If the rupees are given, you just have to convert, otherwise it will be simple addition or subtraction. Just see my practice time 2. Here is the adding. Just add from the right hand side. 0, 5. Here is the 0. You just have to put point here. It is the 0. 4 plus 1 is 5. And 6 plus 3 is 9. Okay. Now here 0, 0, 0, 0 plus 5. 5. Put the dot here. Because dot separates the rupees and paise. 6 plus 4 is 10. So 0. Carry 1 here. 7, 8, 9, 10 plus 1, 11, carry 1, 9 plus 1, 10, 11, 12, 13. So here I have to write 13. So how much is this equal to? Rupees 1310 rupees and 50 paise. Okay, in this way you have to do the addition of remaining one. You know how to add. Okay, now what about the subtraction? Just see, started from the right hand side. 0 minus 0 is 0. 5 minus 0 is again 5, and it is the point. 5 minus 0 is 5. 6 minus 4 is 2, and 7 minus 1 is 6. Okay, now see the second one. 0 minus 0, again 0. 5 minus 0 is again, 5. Next, 6 minus 4 is 2. You just have to point here. 7 minus 1 is 6, and 8 minus 2 is 6. Okay, so in this way you have to do the addition and subtraction of remaining one. Just see what problems are given there. Given below are the some objects that you can buy from a bookstore. See their prices and answer the question given. Just see, From these, the question is, if you go to the bookstore with a 500 rupees note, okay, and you have to buy three things, which three things you choose, how much would you pay for them in all and how much you will get back, okay? Now, see, which things you have chosen there, if you are going to the bookstore with the 500 rupees and you just have to buy the three things, means the things which are under the 500, you just have to choose this one. That is, you can choose these 25 rupees, 55, and you can use a 95, okay? Just see, if you have taken the book of rupees, you have tried rupees and paise, okay? Now, here, if you have choose the lunchbox of 95 rupees, 75 paise, and then book of 55 rupees, 25 paise, and ruler of 25 rupees, okay? Then what is the addition? Just see here. 0, carry 1, 0, carry 1, 16, carry 1, 176. So, your things are with the 76 rupees and you are gone with the 500 rupees. So, you just have to subtract 500 minus 176. Okay. So, what will be the answer? Just see here the 4, here 10, cut it as 9 and here is the 10. It is the 4, 2 and 3 means you are left with the 324 rupees, okay? Now, again some questions are related to this much is given here. You just have to read and solve the in such a way, okay? Now, here you also question 4. Now you are going to the higher class and you teacher says you cannot write with a pencil anymore. What items would you buy from the shop to take a school? What is its cost? Okay, so it is solved by your students. Now, the next one is multiplication and division involving money. We multiply or divide money the same way as we do with the numbers, okay? So there is no difference on multiplying and dividing. You just know how to multiply and divide. In this way, you have to multiply and divide. Now, the first is, if Mans is paying rupees 614.50 for one bottle of olive oil and she needs 7 such bottles, how much will it cost her? Yes, just see, for one olive oil bottle, she spent the 614.50 rupees. And for the such 7 bottles, she should pay the 4301.50 rupees. So you just have to simply multiply and see where is the point. You just shift the number from right to left. Okay. Now, Sheetal gets rupees 1515 as packed money per month, okay, a pocket money per month. So her pocket money is equal to 1515, okay, from her dad. If her dad gives her an equal amount every week, what does she get every week? Okay, now she is getting 1515 in a month, but if she wants same equal amount in every week, so how many weeks are there? 4 weeks. So in a month, 4 weeks are there, so you just have to divide by 4. How much she gets? She will get every week 378 rupees 75 paise. Okay, are you understood, student? It is a very easy one. Now see my practice time 3. Multiply the following. You just have to multiply and write down the answer. Just see, the first one we are done. 759 rupees, 759.50 and multiplied by 12, okay? Now, you directly multiply by 12 or you can multiply by 2 and the 1. So, you just have to multiply it by 2, okay? Now, 200, 2 5s are 10, carry 1. 2 9s are 18 plus 1, 19, carry 1, 5 2s are 10 plus 1, 11, carry 1, 7 2s are 12 plus 1, 13, okay. At last, you have to write the, you have to put the dot. Means, you just have to separate the money and paise at the last. 10, 0, 1 5s are 5, 1 9s are 9, 1 5s are 5, 1 7s are 7. And just add the number, 0, 0, 14, carry 1, 10 plus 1, 11, carry 1, 8 + 1 = 9 and 7 + 1 = 8. Now see, after the how many points are there at the decimal point? 1, 2. So just repeat from 1, 2. So what will be the answer? Yes, 8914. Okay. So this is the simple one. You just have to multiply and shift the number from right to the left after the 2 decimal point. Okay. Here also 2. Here also 2. Here also after the 2 decimal points, you just have to shift the number. Okay. Now again, you just want to see the 432.50. B1 432.50 and multiplied by 32. Okay. Now this is the rupees. Now 2 0 0 2 5 are 10, carry 1 2 2 are 4 + 1 5, 3 2 are 6 and 4 2 are 8. Here you have to write. Then 3 0 0 3 5 are 15, carry 1 3 2 are 6 + 1 7, 3 3 are 9 + 1 10, carry 1 4 3 are 12 + 1 13. Where is the 0 0 0? You carry 1 7 + 7 = 14, carry 1 9, and here is the 13 after the 2 decimal point, 1 2. So what will be the 13,940 rupees. Okay, in this way you have to multiply the number. Just see the division. Yes, divide the following rupees 5670.50 to the by 25. Okay, just write the number 25 here and write the number here 5670.50. So just consider the two number 25 2 are 50, subtract it 6, bring it down 7 67. So 25 2 are 50, 25 3 are 75, means it is the greater one. So 75, you just have to write 25 2 are 50. Again, 1 7 0 is down. In the table of 25 is 170 is present. 25 5 are 150. 25 6 are 150. So when the 0 is there, you just have to put the sign. Here is the 2 0, then 5. 25 8 are. Yes, 25 8 are 200. Then here is the 5 0 0 and last is the 5. So 50, 25 2 are 50. Okay, just subtract the number. Now what will be the answer? It is equal to rupees 226.82. Okay, now you know how to divide the number. In this way you have to divide. Just see the B1 also. B is rupees 9976.50 and it will be divided by 9. So 9 1s are 9, 0 here, again 9 1s are 9, subtract it here 0, bring it down 7. So 0 here 76, 9 8 are 72, just subtract it. Here is the 4.95 are 45, then subtract it and at last you just have to put 0 0 0. Okay. Now what is the answer? That is rupees 1108.50. Okay. So students, have you understood how to multiply and divide the number? Yes. Now see, moving to the next, that is word problems are given there. The school cricket team won the trophy match and got prize money rupees 4872 from the sponsor. Okay, they got an additional bonus of 2400 for their school. If the number of recipients is 16, what is the total amount received by each participants? Just see. So the first one, what is given? Yes, they got. So you just have to write they got prize money. Okay, they got prize money is equal to rupees 4872 and then additional bonus. So then here you have to write additional bonus, it is equal to how much? Rupees 2400. So you just have to add this number. Therefore total amount they got, how much they got, is equal to rupees 4872 plus rupees 2400. So it is equal to, just add the number 2772. Okay, they are got the 7272 rupees. And how much are recipients are there? So you just have to write the number of recipients is equal to 16. So in the 16 recipient, this total amount is divided. So just write it as, therefore, amount received by each participant, it is equal to rupees 7272 divided by 16. Okay, just have to do the calculation. So it is equal to, when it is divided by 16, it will give 454.5, means each participant is getting the rupees 454 rupees and 50 paise. Okay, now see the second one. An old refrigerator was sold by a grandparents for rupees 6797. Okay, now so you can say refrigerator sold at rupees how much? 6797. Then the money was distributed amongst his 14 children, grandchildren. So money distributed to how much grandchildren? That is 14 children distributed to grandchildren. How much are there? 14. So therefore, each grandchild get amount is equal to rupees of 6797 divided by 14. So it is equal to how much? Again, 485 rupees, and how much is equal to 5 or 50. Yes, okay. Now in this way you have to do the all remaining one, follow the same method. Okay, now moving to the next topic, that is bills. Okay, now all items are measured by their quantity, that is length, volume or weight, or by their value. Generally, things are manufactured and sold to meet the needs of the customer. For example, you can get a 50 gram toothbrush tube for your travel kit, as well as 200 gram family pack of toothpaste of daily use at home. Yes, when we shop, we buy according to need and with a budget in mind. The traders who make these available to us are registered with the government. They need to have regular bills and accounting systems in place to show what they sell and how much they earn. Bills are very important. Yes, students, when you are going to the shop, the shopkeeper given you the bill. Yes, so both for the traders and customers. They help the traders in listing the items sold and money collect by them. They also help the customer check the prices and amount charged. Yes, you know, when you are going to the DMart, they are given the bill. Yes, according to the rate of the yes things. Okay, now generally bills have the following details, which details are billing having. The just see, name and address of the shop. Yes, the bill number to the help the customer trace back any details letter. Then name of the items with their quantities, the rate at which the items are sold, and the sum of the prices of the items and other charges or taxes which may be charged. Yes, now let us look at a few samples of bills. Vegetable or fruit market and general stores. Just see, when you are going to the fruit shop, just see, he is given a bill like cauliflower quantity 1 kg, per kg is equal to 20. You are given a 1 kg means 20. Then mangoes quantity 6, per dozen is 48. So according to it, it is 24. Potato again, then tomato, bananas, beans. Means in this way you have taken the things that will be your bill. Okay, now see, what about the food world supermarket? Jassi. Hair cream. If you are taken the 100 gram, then it will price is 45. When you are taken one, it is 45. Then apple juice of 1 liter bottle, the rate is 93 rupees. If you are taken the one bottle, it is equal to 93. Then wheat, 2.5 kg if you are taken, and it is the rate of 18 kg per. Then what is the amount is 45 rupees. Again, mustard, cooking butter, ice cream, strawberry juice, ketchup, all the things if you are buy from these according to their rate, they are totaling here, and you have to pay 452 rupees. Okay, now in this way you know how to calculate the amount and write in the bill. Okay, now see, my practice time 4 is given there. Shiva went to Rajaram's provision store and brought 2 kg of tuvar dal at rupees 43.50. Rupees 43.50 means 83 rupees 50 paise per kg. 3.5 kg of mung dal at rupees 71.70 per kg, 5 kg of rice at rupees 52 per kg, and 100 gram of mustard at 85 per kg, and 250 grams of jeera at rupees 200 per kg, and prepare a bill and find the total cost. Find out how much he should get back if he gives a rupees 1000 note to the shopkeeper. Okay, just make a bill. Now first, how to make the bill? You just have to first write the name of the shop. So you have to write Rajaram Provision Store. Okay, then after that, what you have to write? You just have to write here is address. So Rajaram Provision Store, then write here the address is not given. Okay, then according to the bill, you just have to write here the items. Okay, item, then here you have to write quantity, then rate, here you have to write in rupees, then amount in rupees. Okay, now just see the item, which items it is taken. First one is tuvar dal. Here you have to write tuvar dal. How much it is? 2 kg. Okay, and price, what is the price of tuvar dal is 83 rupees 50 paisa for 1 kg, and it is taken the 2 kg, means it is equal to multiplied by 2, so 83.50 multiplied by 2, it is equal to 167 rupees. Okay, now then 3.5 kg of moong dal. So right here, moong dal, moong dal, how much it is? 3.5 means you can write it as 3.5 kg. So of which rate it is 71.70 per kg. Okay, so you just have to do, write 71.70 multiplied by how much? 3.5, because it is the 3.5 kg, so it is equal to how much? 250 rupees and 95 paise. Then what? 5 kg of rice, then here you have to write rice, how much it is? 5 kg at the rate of 52 rupees. 52 rupees per kg. So when it is 52 rupees per kg, so what about the 5 kg? It is equal to 260 rupees. And then 100 gram of mustard, then it will have to write mustard, how much it is? 100 gram, and it, here is the given 100 gram mustard at 85 rupees per kg. So 85 rupees per kg is given, okay, and it is taken the 100 grams, so it is equal to 8.50 rupees. Okay, now then 250 gram of jeera, how much? 250 gram. Okay, 200 per kg. So what about the 250 gram is 50, so you have to write 50 rupees. And again, okay, now okay, it will be finished. Now you have to just finalize it, means you just have to add the numbers. You write here gram, this is the rate of per kg. Okay, Now add the number. Total sum you just have to do. That is 167.00. Okay, 167 plus 250.95 plus 260 plus 8.50 plus 50 rupees. Okay, now it is equal to 736.45. Yes, the total cost is equal to 736.45. Now if he gives a rupees 1000, if you are given rupees 1000 is equal to means 1000 minus 736.45. So it is equal to, just subtract the number, 1000 minus 736.45. So you will get 263 rupees and 55 paisa back. Okay, so students, are you understood how to make the bill? Okay, you can make in a, yes, you, here the two examples are given. So here you have to again write the date also. Okay, so here you have to write date, but date is not mentioned here, so you just have to write by your own. Okay, now your bill number is again given, bill number. Now you can make this anyway. So students, are you understood how to make the bill? Yes. Okay, now end with this practice time 4. We have finished the lesson number 5, that is money. Okay, so I hope all the topics in the lesson number money you will understood very well. Okay, so with this hope, today we are finished our lesson number 5, money. Now we are meeting in the next class. Thank you so much, students.